Hi folks, hope you're okay today. It's good to be with you. I'm in Scotland today, in Paisley near Glasgow, and I've been up here for about 3 days. And it's been a fantastic 3 days. It's basically some friends of mine in the Nazarene denomination who studied with me invited me up to meet them and to have fellowship and to enjoy the conference. And I really enjoyed it. It was a real blessing. There was a lot of stuff that helped me to think things through. I think I was challenged about prayer. There was a French missionary who talked about there was war in the Congo and he didn't know what to do. His wife didn't know what to do, and it was just really difficult to minister to the churches there. Anyway, he spent time in prayer and he saw a breakthrough because of the praying. And I'm reminded that Wesley spent 4 hours in prayer. So I was inspired by that. And I was inspired about the importance of discipleship, the need to disciple and get alongside people and disciple people. And also to be culturally sensitive, to recognize that when we're in different cultures, we have to be sensitive to those cultures. So those were just a few things. I don't want to say anything negative, but personally, that's what I got out of the conference, and it was a tremendous encouragement and tremendous blessing to me anyway. If you turn to the book of Haggai, chapter 1, it talks about in this book, "Then spoke Haggai," verse 13, "the Lord's messenger in the Lord's message unto the people, saying, I am with you, says the Lord. I am with you, says the Lord." And in the book of Haggai, I'd encourage you to read it today. The people were too busy building their paneled houses. And yet the Lord says, you know, what about my house? And we need to be focused on building the kingdom and sharing the gospel and sharing the message of Jesus. But in the book, it encourages that God is with us. And sometimes we can feel overwhelmed by the greatness of the task, overwhelmed by the apathy of the opposition. But God promises us that he's with us. I think of Jeremiah. Just a few devotional thoughts today. Then the word, Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 4, "Then the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest from out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations. Then said I, Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. But the Lord said unto me, Say not, I am a child, for thou shalt go to all that I shall send thee, and whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak." So Jeremiah was reluctant to go, yet God promised that he'd send him and that he'd go with him. And when God calls us and sends us, he goes with us. It's a really encouraging thought that he was with the people of Israel when they came out of Egypt and they came to that river at the sea, and they couldn't cross it, and God parted the sea, and then they were in the desert and they had no resources, yet God provided manna. So if God's with you, he will provide for you, he will defend you, he will help you. And God promises in his word in Haggai that he is with us and that he'll stand with us. I think of Paul when he was on his own and he felt really discouraged, and you know, he said, "But the Lord stood with me." So wherever you are today, whatever you're doing for the Lord, remember that God is with you. He's with you in your family, he's with you in your work situation, he's with you in your ministry. And if you find that you're not getting a breakthrough, just wait on the Lord in prayer and ask the Lord for guidance. Recently, I took 3 days out just praying about vision and about the future. And it was really, it's been a really good 3 days because God's really ministered to me. He's given me a very clear vision of where to go and how to go forward. And sometimes we just need to take a step back and we just need to hear from the Lord. So if you're not getting a breakthrough in your ministry or in your life or in your situation, just be quiet and just say, Lord, speak to me. I'm here to listen. And just go to the services and just listen to the Bible studies or listen to a song or listen to a sermon or read a book or just read the scriptures or something and just say, Lord, I'm here. I want to hear from you. I want to be directed by you. And if you really seek his will, if you really want his will, he will really speak to you. And God's amazing. God will do things. God will just blow your mind. He really will blow your mind. Because he'll start to download to you things that he wants you to do, things that you never thought of. And he'll start to do things in your life where you're just like, whoa, this is amazing. In his providence, the way God directs providence. If I told you some providential thing that's happened while I've been away for 3 days in Scotland, you'd be amazed. And maybe sometime I'll tell you about it. But something really amazing happened while I was away. A providential circumstance that I can hardly believe it's happened. It's incredible. And I'll tell you about it, maybe even today, or at least in the next few days, I'll tell you about it. So I'm going to go into Paisley today, that's where the conference was, it's finished now, but I'm going to go in and I'm going to do a bit of evangelism, so I'll film a bit of that, and then I'm going to go into Glasgow and do a bit of evangelism there and film that. I prayed and prayed about what to do for the future, and the more I prayed, I kind of come to the conclusion that the Lord wants me to set up a ministry called Royal Blood Ministries, and it's kind of to get back to the Whitfield and Wesley revival fire and to encourage open-air preaching, to encourage evangelism, personal evangelism, to encourage practical love, to encourage holiness, and to encourage prayer and unity amongst God's people. So it's kind of like a radical, early Methodist kind of revival movement. Not taking sides on the Calvinist and Arminian thing, just like trying to get people back to that revival fire, really. I've mentioned it to a couple of friends who've helped me and they're kind of catching the vision a little bit, so I'm going to pass more information on and we're going to talk about it, pray it through. And so I'm encouraged about that. And then the second thing is I've been praying about church planting. And the more I think about it, the more I pray about it. I've still got a discuss with a few people about it, but it looks like I'm going to go forward with Presbyterian church plant called Redeemer Presbyterian Church Manchester, kind of like on the similar lines as Tim Keller's church that they started, kind of on those kind of lines. So I'm praying about it. I've got a lot more prayer to do, but that's where it seems I might be going. So if you could pray about that, if you could pray about this Presbyterian church plant. And I want to start planting other churches as well. So I hope to stoke a fire and encourage street preaching and evangelism and radical mission, radical discipleship, church unity, prayer amongst God's people with Royal Blood Ministries, but also to set some roots and teach the kind of theology and preaching in like practical expository preaching with Redeemer Presbyterian Church. Now, So I pray that these things are reality. I need your prayers. Please go to my website, jasonburnspreacher.com. Look at the stuff there. There's loads of good stuff. If you want to understand what Royal Blood Ministry is about, or what I'm about, there's a video on my first page, which is by Go Stand and Speak Ministries. And it's a really excellent video. But if you want to understand my heart, where I'm at, that kind of video is really helpful. So my website's jasonburnspreacher.com. You can get me on Twitter, you can get me on Facebook. And sometimes I'll put videos on Facebook that I won't put on YouTube. Sometimes I'll make comments on Twitter about World Affairs or theology or recommend books or whatever. I'll tell you what's happening or tell you my views on evangelicalism at the time. So from time to time I make Twitter comments. If you want to keep up with them and find out what my opinions are about things, you can follow me on that. And there's going to be a new website called Royal Blood Ministries with a video channel, YouTube channel, Twitter and Facebook for that. And so I'll be posting my videos regularly on the Royal Blood Ministries YouTube channel. That'll be my main channel in the future when I get it sorted out. So those are my thoughts today. I feel really peaceful, really calm, and really blessed, really. Looking forward to today. So don't forget to read Haggai. It's a great book. Verse 4, Haggai 2, verse 4. Yet now be strong, O Zerubbabel, saith the Lord, and be strong, O Joshua, son of Jozadak, the high priest, and be strong, all ye people of the land, saith the Lord, and work, for I am with you, says the Lord of hosts. That is for you. That is for you. Get on and do what God has called you to do, and don't shrink back. All right, I'm going to pray. And don't forget to go to a few websites that I like. I like Legionnaire Ministries. I like the resources that they provide. I like Al Muller's briefing. I listen to it often in the mornings. That's Al Muller's briefing. It's really good. He tells you about world affairs, what's happening. And on Legionnaire Ministries, there's Renewing Your Mind, which I listen to most mornings. R.C. Sproul's, what R.C. Sproul might say, or one of his staff. Yeah, those are two websites that I kind of listen to every morning, really. Also, Know Your Bible by Stuart Olliott is a very good Bible teacher that I find inspires me and encourages me. I think couple of preachers that I found a blessing recently is Sinclair Ferguson's ministry, and I think it's Derek Thomas, Presbyterian minister and theologian in America. And a guy called, I think it's Jay Vesco, Presbyterian minister, I found very helpful. Found these guys very, very warm, humble, gracious, learned, compassionate, with unction. I found them a real blessing recently. Okay. I think you can get Vesco from Monergism if you go on to Monergism. And if you type in Derek Thomas, I think it's First Presbyterian Church of something. And St. Clair Ferguson, there's some really good sermons by him. And I think you can get Derek Thomas and St. Clair Ferguson on Legionnaire Ministries. Dr. Godfrey is a really good theologian on church history at Legionnaire Ministries. I really enjoy him. He's very, I like theologians and pastors that are gracious and humble. And that's what I like. I like that graciousness. I like that humility. But I like the unction and the learnedness and the graciousness. And these are the kind of theologians that I and pastors that kind of I look up to and admire and find a real blessing. So let's pray. Father, we come before you today and we confess every sin before you. Father, forgive us our weakness and forgive us, God, that we do not see your holiness and your greatness as we should. You are truly a great and mighty God. God, we confess every sin before you. We thank you that in your word it says there is now no condemnation to them that are in Christ. And Father, we bow before you today. We thank you for your goodness and your love and your blessings. Father, I pray for those who support me on the internet, those who watch my videos and maybe have prayed for me and been a supporter, even if it's just thinking about me. And I pray for each one of them, Lord, that you would surround them with your love and compassion and grace. And I pray for each one of them that they'd be strengthened in their faith and that you bless them in their ministries. Father, I pray for those who are my enemies, whoever they are, skeptics or whoever they are, Lord. I just pray that, Father, you would be merciful to them and show them your grace and your love. Father, forgive me for my own sin, for my own failure. Lord, I truly want to walk your way and serve you and bring glory to your name. I thank you, Father, for this lovely holiday and conference that I've had for the last 3 days. I thank you for the ministry. And I thank you for the Nazarene people. I thank you for the worldwide denomination that they have. And we pray for our brothers and sisters in the Nazarene church, that, Father, their ministry would prosper, that they would go deep in your word, that they would preach the word of God faithfully, that their seminaries would be sound biblically, their ministers would be red hot preachers of the gospel, and their people would be people inspired to pray. We thank you for these people and all the blessings that you've given them worldwide. We thank you, Lord, that there is one Lord, one baptism, one Saviour. I thank you, Lord, that though I hold to the Westminster Confession, and though I am Presbyterian, I have my brothers and sisters in the Nazarene Church, Lord, who love you and who seek to serve you. And I pray for your people, wherever they are, where they hold to the fundamentals of the faith. We pray that you would encourage them. We pray that you would strengthen them. We pray that you bless them. Thank you for this day, for your love and your grace. And I thank you, Lord, for your people. I thank you that we're all one in Christ. I thank you for your salvation. I thank you for your grace. I thank you, God, that you're greater than we could ever imagine. That you can do more than we could ever imagine or think. I prayed a few days ago and asked that you blow my mind. And Lord, you answered my prayer, and you blew my mind. You showed me in your providence how you work, and in your greatness. And Father, I thank you. So may God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us all forevermore. Amen. 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 So I've got to leave the hotel in about 15 minutes. So it's good to be with you, and God bless you. Take care.